Studios. This is Webcast One Live.
No matter how well you drive, stuff happens.
Angry? Who's angry?
And with so many ways to damage your car, there's one right way to fix it.
Minor Wreck Express saves you time and money.
Minor Wreck Express on Northwest Beaver Drive in Johnston.
Well, hi, I'm Rob Spearman. I'm a broker owner of RE/MAX Real Estate Concepts in Des Moines, Iowa. Give us a call if you're looking at buying or selling a home, or if you're having trouble on your mortgage payments or looking to purchase foreclosures, we have the agents to help you. Experienced, outstanding agents. Our office number is 515-276-2872. Or if you'd like to look at homes, go to our website, homeconnectusa.com.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, one will.
Hi, welcome to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggy, and we have quite a few guests tonight. We had a very exciting weekend. We have Susan Campanar. She went with us this weekend, and we went to Pete and Emily Mackey's home in Decatur, Nebraska, and we also went to Kurt and Val Lubin's home in Vermilion, South Dakota. So we had a fantastic weekend with all kinds of meetings and all kinds of healings. I think there was at least 150 people really healed this weekend. And I know that sounds like a lot, but you know, when you hit a lot of places and God is with you, it's not so hard. So it was amazing. And so are you there, Pete and Emily?
We're there.
Hi.
Oh, hi. How are you guys doing?
Great.
Well, good. So can you remember some of the things that happened this weekend?
Well, it was a lot. It was awesome. It's hard to remember them all, but I do remember several knees got healed. Several ears were opened up. And the little boy in crutches, his hip was healed. The hip and leg was healed. That was the pastor's grandson.
Yeah, his name was Mikey. And he had, I think it was called a degenerative disease in his hip. And so they told him it would get worse. And after we prayed for him, well, Dave and I both got a word of knowledge about that and prayed for him. And all the pain left. And then he was walking around without his crutches. And he was praying for people. And the power of God was coming through him. It was really cool, wasn't it?
Right. That was nice to see the kids that got activated.
Oh,
they
were
running around praying for people.
Amen. Yes, he prayed for quite a few people. I think he prayed for the lady that, I think her name was Mary. Or no, maybe that was the other lady. The one that had the red shirt on, that her knees got healed. Her husband was a pastor, too. They did a street ministry. Her knees were healed, and he was the one that prayed for her.
Yeah.
I think her name was Carol Jones.
What?
I believe her name was Carol Jones.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I do have that. Okay. Thank you. She was one of them. There was just so many, it's hard to keep track of them. And she was wound for sound. We've got her testimony on the website already. And the pastor, he said he was 80 to 85% healed on the testimony. And so I didn't know he wasn't healed all the way. So it's like, okay, well, let's pray for you again. We want you to be totally healed. So he was like, oh, it's even better now. He said, I'm going to go play basketball. He was all excited. So what, that's the church that you guys go to, right?
Yeah.
And it was Amazing Grace Mission.
With more than I, because I usually work on Sunday afternoon.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so, yeah, Pastor Van Hook, Amazing Grace Mission. He's originally out of Kentucky.
Mm-hmm.
He's quite a fella. He's remodeled that whole gym, and he's going to turn it into some kind of a youth center.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's great. And his wife got healed of something. Do you remember what she was healed of?
Yes, acid reflux.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you're right. Because I'd had that before, and she had such pain right here. And just, it was like bothering her right then and there as we were praying for. So it kept, we had to pray a few times. It got less and less and less. But, you know, we just keep praying. We don't like to give up. So you guys got a chance to pray for some people this weekend. Do you remember what happened?
I prayed with a pastor who had a murmur in his heart, and of course we couldn't tell whether it was healed or not, but I imagine when you go back to the doctor there will be some change.
Okay. Well, we'll have to get back with that later and find out how he's doing.
She did some on the phone, too, while we were there. You talked to a few people on the phone, Emily, while we were there?
Oh, after the meeting?
Yep.
Oh, okay. What did you find out?
You prayed for a lady while we were eating breakfast.
Oh, that was at my home. Okay. Yes.
You said all the pain left. I heard you talking.
Yes, I can't remember what it was now.
You remember
Pete? Two or three gals from Sioux City that called Emily from the meeting that we had up with Pastor Wally Green. And Tom Salmon let us sit in the back and pray for people for healing. And since then, that they've been calling and bringing their friends to Emily, too.
Oh, okay. Another gal I spoke to on the phone, and Pete was there also. She was an elderly lady, and she had to move to a assisted living, and that night we prayed for her for anxiety and also for her knees, and both of them, she was fine after we prayed on anxiety, and her knees was healed instantly.
Well, you had a thing going on at Tom's. You had somebody that was in the parking lot. Their back got healed.
Yeah, I went out before Emily, and she I was getting in the car, and this guy came over the window, and he asked me to start talking, I said I was in a car accident about a year ago, and he said my back got hurt, and I said, are you in pain? And he says, well, yeah. And so I said, well, let's pray. And I got out of the car, walked over, and I grabbed his hands, and I prayed, you know, in the name of Jesus and the Father, Holy Spirit, you know, be healed. And I heard a big crack, just like that. And I said, you hear that? I said, you got healed. And I was more excited than he was. I started dancing around. You know, I was really thrilled to death. You don't get a lot of instant miracles, you know.
Praise God.
Yeah, that was fun.
Well, there was other people that got healed at the meeting, too. And I think it was Carol Jones, she was so excited. She was just jumping up and down and jumping up and down. And then God used her to pray for many people that were healed. I've got Ken Adair, his hip was healed. Donnell Smith, her knees were healed. And then Rodney was set free of fear and anxiety. And Angel Reed, her foot was healed. And then Jane Green, Pastor Wally's wife, she had carpal tunnels and the pain left in her hand. So praise God. I don't know if you guys were around when any of that was happening.
Yes. I prayed with Jane also, and she still had a little bit of pain. I asked if she had arthritis, and I prayed against that, and then the pain left.
Oh, good. All right. And there was another one. Oh, this was so funny. Do you want to tell it, Susie?
Before we had left, Dave was working on the pool and a piece had broken and he had a big cut on his arm. And one of the little four-year-old there, yeah, saw the cut on Dave's arm, and Dave was kind of down on the floor. And the little boy ran over to Dave and says, "I want to pray for you." And he stuck his hands on Dave's head and said a quick little prayer and then took off. Just like that. But it was just the cutest thing that this little four-year-old little boy just wanted to pray for Dave because he wanted his arm healed.
I thought that was just so precious.
It was adorable.
I didn't even know how it happened. All of a sudden, I just looked and I saw him with his hands on Dave's head, and it was like, what's going on?
He stuck his hands on Dave's head and just prayed for him real quick and then ran off.
That was so precious. And that was Mary's son. Do you guys remember his name?
Hayden.
Oh, yeah, that sounds right. He was just, yeah. He's a little spitfire. He's going to be a preacher, and he's going to go after people for the Lord when he gets a little bit older. Although not, he can do it now too, but he's really going to be used mightily by God.
Well, how many of the little kids did you lead to the Lord?
Oh yeah, the pastor. I don't know if it was you or me that told him that I prayed for everybody that I pray for gets filled with the Holy Spirit, and it's obviously not me, it's the Lord. But he said, "Well, I want you to say the sinner's prayer first." And so I did. And there were seven little kids that came up and said the sinner's prayer. They repeated after me. And it just hits your heart when that happens. It's just so cool because you know that these little kids are going to be in the right place when they end up there. Hopefully a long time from now. But it just really touched me. And then they got filled with the Holy Spirit too. So that was just really neat, and I know it touched everybody in the audience when stuff like that happens. That's really cool. Sometimes it's hard to talk. But there was a 7-year-old. Well, I know that was one of the ages of the kids that got filled with the Holy Spirit. I don't know, there was four boys and three girls or whatever, vice versa, but it doesn't matter. And it just matters that they got it. And it was just an amazing night. Do you guys remember anything else from that night?
Well, I remember the situation that when you were sitting up there with all the little kids, and it was just a sight to behold, you know. It just makes you realize that that's what it's all about, you know.
Amen.
You know, the kids are our future, you know.
Oh, yeah. They sure are.
That's really wonderful.
Do you remember anything else from that night, Susan?
No. Okay. Just how wonderful it was to see everybody that was saved and delivered and set free. And, well, I got a word of knowledge that night about a man that was there. And it had to do with his work, and he said no, and he didn't have a job, Mm-hmm. And his fiance came in later and said that it was his brother.
Oh, okay.
That was having problems at work, that was being threatened at work.
Mm-hmm.
And so we said prayer and used him and said prayer for his brother through him.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what did you do for the first time there?
That was in South Dakota when I brought a young lady to the...
No. What did you do the first time in Nebraska?
Oh, on
you
the...
In the car, you said, I got to minister to ministers. Yeah. I didn't know they were ministers.
Yeah, I was praying for a man and then found out he was a minister. And I just, it was amazing. It was amazing. It's one of those that if you know what you're doing before, then it's...
it scares you.
Kind of scares you a little bit, but it was amazing that I was able to do that.
Yeah. There was one lady that had holy laughter, too. I can't remember her name. But she was at that church, and then when we went to the other church on Sunday morning, she was there again. And she,
doing the same thing.
Yeah, she got a jolt of the holy laughter again. And she's like, Dave's like, come here. And she's like, no. She knew what was going to happen to her. But she did. She really did want it in the end. But she knew she was in trouble. God was going to get her again. But sometimes, you know, that's the way God just breaks things off of us, is through that holy laughter. People get healed when they go through that.
Yep.
People have walked out of their deathbeds in hospitals by doing that.
Yeah, amen.
Bible says the joy of the Lord is my strength.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Oh, and we got to go to Heaven is for Real. It was a testimony and a workshop about a little boy that was 2 years old, and he went to heaven. And when he came back, yeah, like Dave. Dave went to heaven when he was that age, too. Three other times also, but... this little boy went to heaven, and when he came back, he was trying to tell his parents about it, and they just weren't really listening. Of course, they were in shock because of all the different things that were going through at that time with him in the hospital and everything that happened. What was he had appendicitis, and it burst.
It ruptured.
Yeah.
It ruptured.
And so it was like infection all in his body, mm-hmm. So he was in the hospital for like 17 days, and... He went to heaven, and they wrote a book about it, and it was so neat to hear everything that God is using from them out of that. We were in, where were we? We were in South Dakota then.
Sioux Falls.
And we got to hear from the author that wrote it, and from both of his parents, and from the young boy, and what all he experienced, and how he saw Jesus, and he said that he had to go back, and he didn't want to go back, but...
And Jesus told him he had to go back.
Yeah, and he got to meet his grandpa, called Pops, and he'd never met him because he had died when his father was seven. And so he was telling him about how they went fishing and different things that they got to do. And so his parents were like, you know, they didn't tell him all these details, and that he had two sisters, and... only one on earth, the other one was in heaven, and he got to meet her, and she looked like his other sister. But it's just so neat how God uses those stories to help people. The mother had a miscarriage, and so it's helped other people to be healed from having miscarriages, is because they hear her story, and now she knows, you know, that her baby's in heaven.
Yep.
And got to hear about it. And so it helps heal some of those wounds. And the dad said, you know, some people don't know if their relatives are in heaven. And so if people that are on earth tell other people, their family members, about God and that they've accepted Jesus into their heart, then when they go to be with the Lord, they're not worried about him. So I thought that was really a good fact to bring out. And we got to take a quick break here, so we'll be right back, Pete and Emily. Thanks. Hang on.
Okay.
It's commercial time. Are you there, Maddie?
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
no matter how well you drive, stuff happens.
Angry? Who's angry?
And with so many ways to damage your car, there's one right way to fix it.
Minor Wreck Express saves you time and money.
Minor Wreck Express on Northwest Beaver Drive in Johnston.
Well, hi, I'm Rob Spearman. I'm a broker owner of RE/MAX Real Estate Concepts in Des Moines, Iowa. Give us a call if you're looking at buying or selling a home, or if you're having trouble on your mortgage payments or looking to purchase foreclosures. We have the agents to help you, experienced, outstanding agents. Our office number is 515-276-2872. Or if you'd like to look at homes, go to our website, homeconnectusa.com.
If your knowledge of the Word of God exceeds your obedience to the Word of God, you're backslidden. I don't care how excited you are.
Let me ask you something. Is the Fivefold Ministry really equipping you? Because to me, it looks like they're just exploiting you.
What do you mean you don't have faith? What have they been feeding you all these years? After we're finished training you, you won't have to chase anointings anymore. You'll walk in the one you've got.
The RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios. This is Webcast One Live.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory.
Hi, welcome back to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggy. And we have Susan Campanar and Pete and Emily Mackey on the air for a few more minutes anyhow. Dave reminded me, Emily, that you got up and you started preaching when we were at church. And you did a really good job. Do you remember? Hello? Are you there? Pete? Emily?
I remember.
You remember what you said?
I think I talked about how happy I was that when I found out that my purpose for ministry was the Great Commission.
Amen.
We all have been given the ministry of reconciliation.
Yeah.
But
right.
We are being trained to do that through John G. Lake Ministry.
Amen. Yeah, and you guys have been through the DHT, the New Man series, the SWAT one, and I know you guys watch it at home, too, so it's just really a good thing. What would you say to most people? What would your recommendation be, or if somebody asked you about it, what would you say?
Well, there's a difference between telling someone to go out and do these things. Most lay people do not understand how to do it. And Gary Blake, who does the John G. Lake Ministry, mm-hmm. he actually teaches and trains you. He lets you practice, and he is a wonderful teacher.
Can you speak up a little, Emily?
Okay.
Thank you.
Johnny Lake, his training is what enables you to do the Great Commission.
Amen. What would you say, Pete?
Well, that night, I took that fellow back that was in a wheelchair. We prayed for him, and he got some healing. And I took him back to the nursing home, and I prayed for him again. And he said, you pray just like them guys. You know, and I said, I should, because I said, I trained under them, you know. Oh, holy God, you know. So we
Amen.
Sound a lot, Jamie, when we pray.
So do you have any other advice for people out there?
Yes. Find someone who can help you nearby you or can actually give you the training by TV and be there to help you along the way.
Amen.
Well, it's getting results. So many times we've been talked, and it's actually praying with power and getting results.
Yes.
I mean, since you've been through it, how's your results come?
They keep getting better all the time.
Amen.
How about your confidence and your boldness?
Oh, yes. Yes, yes, yes.
You know that you can do it, don't you?
Yes.
Right.
I know it's not me. It's Jesus
right.
and the Holy Spirit.
Right.
And I have to have confidence in them.
I know our instructions were go out and pray for 20 people. And if they don't get healed right away, you keep praying until they do. And then when they start getting healed, then you go back and pray for the ones that you started out with, you know.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And I did that, and it works.
Yes, it
works.
It does. It does, yeah. And you guys are going to continue to do it too, aren't you?
Yeah.
Right. Amen.
I mean, in your town, have you ever seen anything like that before? That many people getting healed that quickly?
No.
I was just in awe again. I was just amazed.
I think this is the first time there was actually a healing meeting in ministry.
In town. Yeah.
For town.
Well, we plan on coming back, so. You just tell the people there that there wasn't actually very many people from your town, I guess you said. There were mostly ministers from other towns that came in to hear about it and see what was going on. So I imagine there's a few people left in that town that still need healing, huh?
Oh, yeah. It was
kind of like popcorn popping. That's what we call it, because it's just like poof, poof. It's just one after another, and it's just so cool. We love to see God work like that. And, you know, when there's people that get healed, and the people from that town or people that know each other, and they know what was wrong with them, and then they see how they're healed, it's like, wow. Then they can believe it for themselves because they just saw somebody else healed, and then it makes it so simple. We praise God, and, you know, we give him all the honor and the glory because it's him, it's not us. It's just that he needs people on this earth, hands and feet, just to go out and touch other people, just to reach out and, like, be Jesus with skin on.
Well, like, today we went down the hospital to the emergency room or the critical care unit, and we were walking out, going the elevator, and there's a guy standing there, and he says, well, how are you doing? I said, well, you probably wouldn't believe me if I told you. Well, I might. I said, well, 10 years ago, I got hit by lightning. I was dead, and I came back to life, and now I pray for people, and they get healed. Really? I said, yeah, we had over 150 people got healed this weekend. Really? And then Patty seen he had a brace on his arm, so I said, she said, can I pray for you? And he couldn't say no. And he says, it's better. So we blasted him a second time. So in less than a minute, all the pain had left his arm.
Amen.
So he wanted to know, hey, will you pray for my wife? They're going to go and do something. And then
surgery
take her to...
on her neck. She had a collar that went from here to here, like one of those metal things. Looked awful.
And she must have been in a car wreck or something, because she had pain in her shoulders and stuff. And I don't know if we blasted her 2, 3, 4 times, and she had no pain in the hallway of the hospital. So they knew it was real. It wasn't just something you talked about. We demonstrated, and he says, look, honey, you know, look at my arm's healed, so we don't have much time because they're getting ready to go in for their appointment.
Yeah.
So.
And then I said, you know what? You need to know how to do this. And so I said, you lay hands on your wife and just grab her and just blast her. And we just say, in the name of Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit, then we just grab their hands and just say, in
life,
light and life, and now, and just tense up your belly when you do that. And just, it's like jumper cables, you know, and just grab them and just let it go through. And then it's just like, he said, wow. He goes, I felt that. And it's like, yeah. And he goes, look at the hair on my arm standing up. Wow. And she felt it too, of course. He's like, this is real. It's like, yeah.
This is the Great Commission that everybody was talking about.
Yep. It was really neat. Well, we thank you very much, Pete and Emily. Thank you for being on the show, and thank you for hosting us while we were there. You guys are just, we just love you guys and had a great time. And we plan on coming back sometime, and hopefully that will work out with you guys too.
Anytime. We're looking forward to it.
Thank you for all your hospitality.
Yes.
You're welcome.
Yes, we had a wonderful time.
Yes.
So, well, we've got Kurt Lubin and maybe his wife or his daughter on. So we'll talk to you guys later, okay? Thank you. God bless. Okay. Well, we're going to hang up with them and then pick up Kurt and his wife is Val. We went to their wedding reception this weekend. And then they just got married in July. Tom Stammen married them with Impact Ministries International. And he actually married Dave and I in October. It'll be 4 years. He married them last February. So they
went, Valentine's Day.
Yeah, Valentine's Day in Hawaii. So they had some really cool pictures. And so we went to their wedding reception and got to meet their family. And are you guys there, Kurt?
Yeah, I hope so.
Oh, we can hear you. All right. Woohoo, you figured it out.
If I'm not here, I don't know where I'm at.
Oh, and you've got Heidi and you've got Val, too. We got all three of you. All right.
Yep.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
Yeah, Susan's here, too.
All right. Hi, Susan.
So what do you guys remember about this weekend? We'll let you guys go ahead and talk.
Well, I would say probably the highlight is the opportunity to host you guys up here in South Dakota, in Vermilion, South Dakota. And, you know, we did some advertising and some personal invites and some email lists, you know, and we had a nice turnout. And but the benefit of everything is that I have a 14-year-old niece that was raised in the church, went to Christian school for 6 years. And she was asked if she'd ever been filled with the Holy Ghost speaking with tongues. She said no. So Susan was praying with her for a little bit. And then, you know, have you ever given your life to Christ? And he led her in the sinner's prayer and she gave her life to Jesus. Hallelujah!
Yeah.
And that was
good.
A big nugget of the night. I mean, there was a lot more things going on, but I was just really excited. And Valerie celebrated the rest of the following afternoon, you know, around the house as she was cleaning up after our reception and after our meeting.
Hey, Kurt, do you have anything going on in the background? We're picking up a lot of background noise.
You know what? I got speakers on.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it just really sounds really loud. Okay. Talk again.
How about now? Is it any better?
Not better.
Much better. Thank you.
The speaker down a little bit.
Okay, good. Thank you. Yeah. So we went to your reception, and I know your brother Keith, his knees were healed, and I think it was his back too.
Yep, his right knee. He'd had about 5 surgeries on it. Recently just had another one, and it was still giving him a little bit of problem, and he asked if he would like to have some relief, and he said yes.
Amen.
I prayed for his back, and he was just pleasantly surprised and had no pain, you know, before he left. And
yeah. Hey, Kurt, you still got some real bad background feed. Do you still have some speakers on there or something? I don't know what it is, but it's just,
It quit when you first did it, and then it started again.
All right, I just unplugged my external speakers.
Okay.
So, and let me turn that off. Okay. Hello. Is this any better?
Yes, that's better. Thank you very much.
You sound like you're drowning.
So, go ahead.
Well, your daughter, she just took like a duck to a water there, and I want to hear her testimony.
All right. What part would you like to hear?
Well, whatever's on her heart.
Well, I guess I've always kind of seen things like in dreams and in visualized, but it kind of hit me that, you know, it's from God. It's not just me. And so I kind of really hit it hard there, and then Dave really helped me out with that and really proved to me that it is from God, not just any human person. So that's speak prophetically. So that was really cool.
Well, I was really proud of you. I called you up front, and you were ministering to ministers and all kinds of people. And what kind of results were you getting?
Instant. I mean, God doesn't wait. As soon as you step out and say, he answers. And people were getting healed, you know. This one I said, you know, in Jesus' name and the power of the Holy Spirit, I should like, and they could just feel it like a wave going through.
Well, Kurt, I don't know what's going on, but it's the same thing. It's like there's this awful, like, monster in the background echoing. Yeah, we're going to try turning ours down and see if it's any better, but go ahead and talk again.
Well, I don't know what interference it would be other than some of negative.
You guys can hear us okay?
Yeah, we hear you fine. But, you know, I mean, it's the first time that I probably used a microphone on this laptop. You know what? I've got it on the stand. And how about if I take that stand off? Maybe there's something ricocheting off of that. Is this any better?
Okay. Well, talk again, and we'll see if it gets any better.
What gets any better? What I'm saying or what you're hearing?
What we're hearing, what you're saying is okay. It's just there's a lot of background feed. That does sound better, too.
Okay, yeah. What I had is I had it on a laptop stand, and we just pulled it off there. I don't know if there's a microphone that might have been muffled or something like that.
Okay. Well, we'll have to go ahead and we'll tell about some of the things that happened. We went to a church on Sunday morning, and you guys got to go with us, and that was a wonderful time. We went to Glad Tidings Church, Glad Tidings Lighthouse Church, and Pastor Ring was there, and you guys got to come with us, and Susan, and your niece, and we got to have a lot of people that got prayed for. We had a hard time just even beginning to keep track. We think that there was probably about 70, 75 people there in the congregation, and it was just one right after another. We got all our mind together and tried to get what happened. We're just saying like 12 people's knees were healed, 6 people's hearings. There was holy laughter that broke out, and a couple of people's hips got healed. One guy that had emphysema. And then there was a lady that had had a baby. Her baby was just 5 days old, and she was just precious. It was like, thank you, Lord. I got to hold this tiny little infant. How I love babies. And, of course, I prayed for her. And she said that she had her baby in an hour, that she came that quickly. And so it really kind of tore up. And so she was in a lot of pain. And so I got to pray for her. And I had to pray for her like 3 times. And it got better and better and better. And then all the pain left. So praise God, she was healed too. And there was a young boy that I got to pray for. He said he hurt his leg playing baseball. And his leg was healed. And then we had all kinds of people come up that were praying for other people. So they got activated. We were just guessing about 12 people because there was just so many different people that were coming up and praying. And so we just praised God that they were so many people that got to see what God does and feel it for himself. Oh, we have to go to a commercial. I'm sorry, guys. Hang on, and we'll be right back in just a few minutes, okay?
Thanks.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
No matter how well you drive, stuff happens.
Angry? Who's angry?
And with so many ways to damage your car, there's one right way to fix it. Express on Northwest Beaver Drive in Johnston.
Well, hi, I'm Rob Spearman. I'm a broker owner of RE/MAX Real Estate Concepts in Des Moines, Iowa. Give us a call if you're looking at buying or selling a home, or if you're having trouble on your mortgage payments or looking to purchase foreclosures. We have the agents to help you. Experienced, outstanding agents. Our office number is 515-276-2872. Or if you'd like to look at homes, go to our website, homeconnectusa.com.
If your knowledge of the Word of God exceeds your obedience to the Word of God, you're backslidden. I don't care how excited you are. Let me ask you something. Is the fivefold ministry really equipping you? Because to me, it looks like they're just exploiting you. What do you mean you don't have faith? What have they been feeding you all these years? After we're finished training you, you won't have to chase anointings anymore. You'll walk in the one you've got.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory.
Well, welcome back to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggy. And we have Susan Campanar here and Val and Kurt Lubin and also Heidi. So thank you guys. I think we might have figured out the technical difficulty. Say hi, guys, and we'll see how it's doing now. Oh no, it's gotten worse. It sounds like you're talking in slow motion. Well, I guess we'll try the phone as far as volume is concerned. And so we'll have her figure that out and we'll just keep talking for a little bit. Keep your picture up if you can, please. And so when we were at Glad Tidings Lighthouse Church, it was in South Sioux City, wasn't it?
Yeah, South Sioux City, okay. Nebraska.
Okay, at Pastor South Dakota. Ring.
Nebraska.
Oh, okay, Nebraska. Okay. I'm sorry. We were in so many places this weekend. It was really confusing. Well, there was, when we were at that church, there was at least 10 people that were set free of different things. And it was like popcorn popping again, just poof, poof, poof. One after another. It was amazing, and it was great because Dave and I and Susan and then Kurt and Heidi and Val and then Kurt's niece, Brianna, everybody was just pitching in and helping out and just one after another. I know Val prayed for a lady that she really got something too. So God was just using everybody. You have them? Oh, okay. I'm sorry. So, and we actually went to a park after that. It was
What happened at the church? That was the neatest church we've been to for a long time. It was so welcoming.
Yes, they were.
I mean, it was like being home at a family.
Yeah, yeah. They were very nice. Pastor Ring was really, he has a heart of gold. Oh, and we went to pray for some of his people Friday afternoon. And there was a guy that had cancer, and he had his ankle. He had all kinds of pins and metal in it. He'd been in a car accident, and it was really swollen and just messed up. And we prayed for it, and he could move his ankle around. And he's like, go get my wife. She was outside. He's like, go get my wife. She's got to see this. He was all excited. And so I did, and Susan noticed that the color came back in his face.
Yep.
So it was like, you know, a lot of times when people are sick, they look kind of ashen and just really pale.
His whole body was full of pain because he was dying.
Yeah.
Pretty much give him no hope. And the pain left his body. And then he's walking around. And his foot with all the iron in it started moving around. And
he had cancer in three different places. And one was in his back, in his spinal cord, and all the pain left. So we're believing that the Lord healed him.
Well, he got up and was walking around.
Yeah.
Even with all the metal in his leg and everything, he was able to move after his wife came in the house.
Mm-hmm.
He said, she's not going to believe this. And he got up and he started walking around the house, and it was like it was nothing.
Yeah.
The pain was all gone. So yes.
Praise the Lord. Really well. Yeah. And then we went to pray for, I think it was the pastor's uncle, and he had cancer too. And we prayed for him, and he felt much better.
He had lung cancer.
Yeah. Oh, and then he could breathe better.
Yep.
So are you guys back on with the phone?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Hallelujah, we can hear you.
Sorry, yeah. Sometimes this stuff that's new, it's hard for us all to figure out, including myself.
we got you on speakerphone here.
Okay, great. We can hear you now. Thank you. Well, Heidi, I know you really got activated and God used you in a mighty way. It was just amazing to see somebody who hasn't really done much of this before. And you just took like a duck to water, and you did a great job. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you.
And it's something that you want to do more of, right?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, remember we adopted you, so we got your room ready.
I'm surprised we didn't see your mom frown on that one. They weren't so sure they really wanted to let her go, though.
No, she's a keeper, but if you'd like to kick in on the food bill, that'd be great.
Well, no. Heidi, what did you think? I asked you there, did you ever have so much fun ministering and seeing so many miracles?
Oh, no. It was a lot of fun. A lot of fun.
Well, seeing all the different hurting people, and you had the answer right there in your hand.
That's something I've never experienced before. It's something that I'll keep experiencing.
Amen.
What did I say to you, Heidi, about bringing your friends into this and in introducing them to this, and what a difference that you young children could make in the world by doing this and taking it out there into the world? What a difference you could make.
Amen. Yeah. And Kurt and Val, you guys did a great job too, praying for people. Thank you so much.
Thank you. It was exciting, and looking forward to having you up again, and probably doing some DHT training in Sioux Falls and Sioux City.
Amen. Yep, we're looking forward to that. Well, we usually pray at 7:45, but since we had a technical difficulties, did you want to right now?
Whatever.
Okay. Well, I'm just going to start out, and if you guys, if the Lord gives you something, we're going to have to do this quickly, but if the Lord lays something on your heart, if you want to just put it out there for somebody that needs healing or something that you know is really important. So, Lord, I'm just asking that you touch people right now, anybody that's listening to this. Lord, if they need you in their heart, that they just ask you in your heart as their personal Savior. We know how much you love us all and that you want to see us in heaven.
Yes.
Go ahead, Kurt.
Yes. Oh, Jesus, we just thank you for the salvation that you provided for us, that we'd be redeemed and restored and reconciled to the Father, Lord, that we advance the kingdom, Lord. And there are people out there that have been sitting in churches and sitting at home, and Lord, empower us and give us the wisdom and the energy to get out there and do the gospel, not just read about it. You know, we can't assume that the people that we know are saved. You know, they might have been churchgoers a long time ago, but they've never given their life to Christ. And so many people want to hold on, or they just have reasoned away their healness. And he's provided a way for them to be healed. He's paid the price already. We just pray, Holy Spirit, that more people would be encouraged to do the gospel and get some training and clean up a little bit of doctrinal theology, if that's what it takes, you know, to put the feet on the street and get people saved, healed, filled with the Holy Ghost, and discipled and baptized and moving forward to. In the name of Jesus, we thank you for all that you've done for us, Lord, and for the friendship with the Loggies and the John G. Lake Ministries training that they've actually found and are sharing and empowering the believers. In Jesus' name, we thank you for that.
Well, I just want to speak life in any hopeless situation, no matter what it is, no matter what you need. Just grab onto it.
Amen. Yeah, we're in agreement. Well, we want to thank you guys. You guys were wonderful. And we just wanted to say a little bit about what happened in the park, too, because we were in the park that was kind of follow-up from the Heaven is for Real. And we got to pray for a couple ladies that were in wheelchairs. And they both had pain throughout their body. I know one of them had been in pain for 20 years. And we prayed for her, and all the pain left. She had no pain anymore. And she's just like, I didn't know what that was like, you know?
Praise God.
And I'm like, do you want to get up and try it? You want to step out of that wheelchair? And she's like, no, not now. When I get home, I will. It was like, oh, kind of heartbreaking. But, you know, all the pain left and she was comfortable. We're just believing that when she gets home, she is going to get up out of that wheelchair and she is going to be totally restored. That's what God did, because God's not a God of halfway. So, and then the other lady, she said, I wouldn't know what it would be like to not be in pain. And she was by the time we were done praying. So praise God for what he was doing there. And there was a guy that God told me to pray for, and he needed to be set free of some things. And I let him pray for me first because he asked me if he could, and I said, sure. And I prayed for him. I just kind of blasted him, and his eyes looked different when after I prayed for him. It's like, thank you, Jesus. He was set free. Do you guys have anything else that you can think of that you wanted to add? Any of the stories throughout the whole entire weekend? We got 4 minutes left.
Let's hear from Val.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is it good to be a part of God's vessel to help fill people with freedom and joy and the Holy Spirit and what he can do for them? And so enjoy being a part of the weekend and the ministry of Dave and Patty and more so of the God that we serve. So.
Amen. Yeah.
Well, you're kind of like a sister that everybody just wishes they had.
Amen.
Well, you know, you have another home up here anytime you are passing by or through.
Thank you so much. We really enjoyed our time. You guys are very welcoming. And, you know, it's neat to be able to minister with other people that have the same ideas on God. And just you guys just went out and just went after it. And people got healed and saved and set free and filled with the Holy Spirit, just like we're supposed to be doing.
Well, your niece was the neatest salvation that I've ever experienced to date. I thought there was way more going on. I mean, that's one of the coolest things on earth anyway, but.
Yeah. Amen.
She was laughing and crying at the same time. Something's going on over there.
And that was a wonderful experience for me.
Oh, yeah.
That was your first.
That was my first.
Yeah.
Yes, that was my first. She was the first one that I brought to the Lord.
Amen.
With the salvation prayer. And it was an awesome feeling for me.
It was.
To know that I brought her to the Lord.
Yeah, that was really cool.
She's an amazing young lady.
Yeah.
An amazing young lady.
Yes.
She has always been very kind and considerate and loving, and had a lot of the earmarks of what you would look for in a Christian.
Amen.
It was like a breakthrough this weekend with you guys up here, and we're talking about the Lord, and we're talking about healings and ministry, and you know, it's just like she no longer wanted to have the God of the universe being read about like in past tense. She wanted to experience him now and in the future and part of her life, and that is just so totally awesome.
Amen. Yeah, it was. It was an amazing time in the Lord. We want to thank you guys again, and we also want to thank all the people. We want to thank Susan for coming with us and helping, and Michael Anderson. He works on our website, and he is amazing. He's done so many wonderful things. We just want to thank him and for his wife and family for sharing him with us with this. His time.
Pastor Ring.
And Pastor Ring, and also Pastor Van Hook, is it? I believe that's how you say his last name. And look forward to seeing them again. And we want to thank people that contribute into our ministry. We couldn't do it without them. And most of all, we want to thank God, because obviously we really couldn't do it without him. He's just done amazing things, and we're just so warmed and thrilled to be able to be used by God in the way that he uses us. And we just want to keep doing God's work. And thank you, Lord. And we will see you guys next week, same time, same place, 7 o'clock. And check out our website for other scheduled events. HSLM.us is our website. So if you have any prayer requests, send them by email or give us a call. Our phone numbers are on there. And thank you for all you do. God bless you guys. Talk to you later, Kurt, Heidi, and Val.
We love you. Bye-bye.
Okay. Love you guys. Bye-bye.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory,